from the beautiful Tarble Arena on the campus of Carthage College, Kenosha, Wisconsin. It's the 2014 College Conference of Illinois and Wisconsin Women's Basketball Tournament. It's the second semifinal game of the evening featuring the number one seed Carthage Lady Reds, regular season champions in the CCIW at 13-1, 22-3 overall, taking on the number four seed, the Elmhurst Blue Jays, 6-8 in conference play, 14-11 overall. Good evening, everyone. John Weiser with you. Crowd still coming into this one here tonight. Still plenty of room for you, as we'll be tipping this one off just a little bit after 7 o'clock, around 7:05 or so. So you still have some time to come on out and check out Lady Reds basketball here tonight, as the Lady Reds won their second straight regular season title and third overall in school history. This weekend, Carthage making its 11th tournament appearance out of the 12 that have been held since 2003. Lady Reds are 4-9 all-time in conference tournament games and enter as the defending champion. Last year was the first time Carthage had won a tournament title. All-American Stephanie Kuzmanic leads her team with 15.4 points per game, 170 assists on the year, amongst the nation's leader in that category at the Division III level this year. Michelle Wenzel, the senior out of Delavan-Darien High School, second on her team in scoring at 14 points per game, and Christy Schmidt, third, with 12.6 per contest. Haley Stursik started every game with Schmidt and Wenzel this year. She averaged just under 10 points per game. Earlier this afternoon, the College Conference of Illinois and Wisconsin announced its all-conference team. Stephanie Kuzmanic was selected as a unanimous choice to the first team all-conference. Michelle Wenzel, also a first team all-conference. Christy Schmidt, the senior out of Bloomington, getting second team all-conference honors. And Haley Stursik landing on the third team all-conference honors. The conference player of the year, the most outstanding player for the second consecutive year, went to Stephanie Kuzmanic, the first back-to-back most outstanding player since Lindsay Ippel did it back in the 2007-2008 campaign for Millikan. And Kuzmanic becomes just the third player in the history of the CCIW women's basketball to win the most outstanding player more than one time. Tim Bernero was named Coach of the Year this year in the CCIW. Again, that was announced late this afternoon. So the Lady Reds going to put those all-conference players to work here tonight, taking on a very good Elmhurst Blue Jay team. This 14-11 record, 6-8 in conference, don't let that fool you here. This is a very good Elmhurst team. This is a team that's making its first tournament appearance since 2010. The last couple of years, they've needed to get that win on the last game of the regular season to get in and fell short. This year, they got that win at home last Saturday that projected them into that fourth spot. They picked up a 95-85 win in the regular season finale against North Central last Saturday. That, with the tiebreaker, they win that fourth seed spot. Their first appearance since 2010, when the Blue Jays advanced to the tournament final against Illinois Wesleyan. This will be the fourth appearance in program history for Elmhurst, as they also advanced to the conference tournament back in 2005 and 2008. They hold an overall record of 1-3 in tournament games. Elmhurst is led by an outstanding first team, make that second team all-conference selection in Fiona McMahon. McMahon out of St. Charles, Illinois, the leading scorer on this Elmhurst team at 14 points per game, also in rebounding at 8.7 per contest. Melody Schwertman, out of Lake in the Hills, Illinois, coming off the bench for 13 points per game. And third-team all-conference Karen Sinet, also averaging in double figures at 10 points per contest. As we said, Elmhurst coming in, they earned the final spot in this weekend CCIW Women's Basketball Tournament with that 10-point win over North Central on Saturday. McMahon scored a game-high 29 points, 12 of 19 from the field, to lead the Blue Jays. Karen Sinet added 24, and Katie Swanson had 11 assists and 10 rebounds, one of those rare double-doubles that did not involve point totaling. So for Elmhurst, they're coming in on a bit of a high roll. Carthage won the outright regular season title with their 77-64 win over Millikan here on the Tarble Arena floor last Saturday. Stephanie Kuzmanic, a game-high 21 points. She was 10 of 11 from the free throw line. She also added 10 assists for her third double-double of the year. Michelle Wenzel added 19 points and 13 rebounds. Another double for Wenzel, and Christy Schmidt, 13 points in that win over Milliken. So tonight, as I said, the Lady Reds have to guard against a letdown here as they get on their home floor. That should not be a problem. The question will be, what is Elmhurst's attitude coming in here? Are they happy to be in the tournament, or are they going to are they in it to win it? What's their attitude going to be? We're going to find out in the very first moments of this ball game. If you go back to the two games these two teams played this season, Carthage winning both of those ball games, but the game here in Kenosha, that was back in January, was an abysmal game for the Blue Jays. They went 7 of 28 in the first half of that contest. They were just 1 for 16 shooting the three ball in dropping that contest 71-33. They finished that ball game shooting just 23%, their low watermark for the year. Then these two teams hooked up again back in the middle of this month, February 12th, in a game in at Faginal Hall, a game that was a lot closer than the score would indicate. Carthage pulling away late, 65-48, but that was a very tight ball game till about 8 minutes left in that contest. And again, Carthage doing it defensively as they limited the Blue Jays just 6 for 32 from behind the arc and just 29% shooting from the floor in that contest. It was Kuzmanic with 19, leading three players in double figures for the Lady Reds in that contest back in February. And it was Michelle Wenzel going 7 of 10 from the floor and 14 points in the victory here at home over the Blue Jays back in January. So third time around for these two teams here tonight. The winner of this game will face Illinois Wesleyan. The Titans defeated Wheaton in the first semifinal game here tonight, 79-66. In that contest, four Illinois Wesleyan players in double figures, led by Lexi Baltas. Baltas with 19 points. She was 5 of 7 from behind the arc in the first ball game. Casey Reber chipped in 18. Colleen McMahon, the scoring title winner in the CCIW, finished with 16. Shelby Jackson had 11. For the Wheaton Thunder, they were led by Hannah Considine. Considine with 24 points tonight. She was 9 of 14 from the floor. Katie McDaniels, the freshman of the year this year in the CCIW, finished with 15 points. She was 3 of 13 from the floor, but she was 9 of 10 from the free throw line. As Thunder shot just 36% in that loss, while Illinois Wesleyan finished the game shooting 49% and 43% from behind the arc, 7 of 16 in that contest. So the winner of the Carthage-Elmhurst game will take on Illinois Wesleyan tomorrow night for the title in the conference tournament and the automatic berth into the NCAA Division III tournament, which gets underway next week, Friday. When we come back, we'll visit with head basketball coach Tim Bernero. We'll get his thoughts on the all-conference selections and a look ahead to this ball game here tonight as our pregame programming continues from the Tarble Arena in Kenosha. This is Carthage Lady Reds basketball on AM 1050 and WLIP.com. Welcome back to the Tarble Arena, everyone, as we get set for the CCIW Women's Basketball Tournament tonight, the second semifinal game. It'll be the homestanding Carthage Lady Reds taking on the Elmhurst Blue Jays, the one seed versus the four seed, joined now by the Lady Reds head basketball coach Tim Bernero. And do a little bit of housekeeping here. Late this afternoon, word came out, the all-conference team selected, and congratulations, Stephanie Kuzmanic, back-to-back most outstanding player of the year, making first-team all-conference. Also, Michelle Wenzel, first-team all-conference. Christy Schmidt, second-team, and Haley Stursick, third-team. And congratulations to you, second straight year coach of the year in the CCIW.
Thanks, John. You always talk about it being a team game, but the kids do earn recognition from time to time, and when you get it from your peers and you get it from your conference, that's important. And Stephanie earned her award, as did the other girls. I mean, I'm really pleased with how that went. Michelle's numbers and everything are in her performance, her first team all conference performance. Christy, sometimes when you have the balance we do, it's hard to get everybody noticed. I mean, you can go past Christy and Haley, and a lot of times these awards come down to what do the other coaches think of you, or who played well against who, because they're the ones voting. I don't get to vote for my own players, so that's just, and neither does anybody else, obviously. So it's how the other teams perceive them. And when they perceive that you've got kids of that quality, and obviously I could go deeper than that. I mean, Erin Quinn's been invaluable. She's leading the conference in assist to turnover, and you've got, you know, Boardman and Hahn and Kleiner have done a really good job all year. So, it, you know, it's nice. You know, the coaching award is recognition of us being, you know, given an opportunity here at Carthage to have a successful program and us doing our jobs like we've been hired to do, I think, you know, to do a good job. And, you know, assistant coaches, staff, you know, athletic director, you know, all the support that we get that way. And then obviously you have good kids that are talented that you've recruited and they perform.
Reading into this, Stephanie, one of three players selected unanimously to the first team. So for Kuzmanic, I think that's the second straight year she won a unanimous vote in on as the first team All-Conference and Player of the Year.
Yeah, and that's, again, that's what the other team sees. I mean, they all agree that she's our best player in some respects, and she's kind of makes things go for us. And they also understand that she's probably the best of the best of a lot of good players in this conference.
I was going to say, this is a loaded conference. I mean, you look up and down the first, second, and third team, all outstanding players, all in their own right, leaders of their respective teams. Illinois Wesleyan with a pair on the first team All-Conference. Ellie Zeller out of Wheaton making first team All-Conference. Katie McDaniel, outstanding freshman. She's going to be something in the next 3 or 4 years here in this league. So everything is, this is a deep league from top to bottom.
Yeah, and that's the thing. You know, Wheaton should, you know, they Kent better not screw that up. He's got the last two newcomers of the year, so they're already loaded deep there. But you know, it's a situation where, you know, you just like the teams, you have to, if you're good at the top level of this league individually or as a team, you're good, you know, as good as anybody nationally, and that's, you know, that's why we get some of the recognition for our kids too, because they're at the top of this league, and this league's excellent.
Second straight year, you've won the outright conference title and awarded the right to host the conference tournament. So going into this, you got a little bit of experience now, back-to-back, understanding how to prep and how to get ready and how to focus here for the second game on a Friday night.
Yeah, and it's a little odd to sit here and watch the other teams in the league play in your own gym, but you know, it's a little bit, there's a relaxing thing because you've played these teams three times now. We've beaten everybody in the building at least once, you know, most of them twice. So you have knowledge of what they're trying to do. You have knowledge of what, you know, and they know have the same of you, but now you're trying to, it's a matter of getting your team ready to do what they do well and then play well when the you know, lights go on at 7 o'clock or 5 o'clock, whenever the game starts. So, yeah, it's much nicer to be in your own gym. It eliminates the travel and the expense and doing all the other stuff that way. And, you know, we expect to have a really nice crowd tonight, and that's what you play for. You want your kids to play in front of your crowd, and you want the college to enjoy the experience and the event.
I guess the question to ask is, are the Lady Reds playing their best basketball when you need them to be playing their best basketball?
You know, I think we're getting back to it. I think, you know, we've had moments where we've been rolling pretty well, and you also get to a point where, you know, I think that when Steph was injured, you know, 3 weeks ago, 2 weeks ago, whenever that was, it kind of, we had to put the brakes on, reorganize for those two games, and we played well. We played well against Wheaton and Augustana. Now we had to inject her back in there, which obviously we were going to do. We were, you know, she's the best player in the league. So, and there was a little bit of a kind of a getting it back at high, at top speed for her and for the flow of things. And, you know, it cost us a game that, you know, on the road, and now we're in a position, I think, where we're starting to feel that, and I think the all the other stuff's kind of put away. I mean, all the awards and all the conference tournament or conference championship is settled. Now let's just play, and you know, there's not pressure to worry about that.
Your opponent, the Elmhurst Blue Jays, finishing fourth in the league. They needed to win the last weekend to get in. They've been in that position a couple of times last couple years, weren't able to get through the door. This year they were able to get to the door, so this may be a hungry opponent here tonight, not bent on just being here, happy to be here. I think they're looking to win a conference title.
And that's what you wonder about. You know, their first time in a while, a handful of years. You know, are they relieved that they just got here, or are they going to come out swinging and flying? Then I would guess it's more the latter, because they've really got nothing to lose. I mean, we handled them pretty good up here. The game down there was closer than the score indicated, but we got away and put the game away in the second half or late in the second half. So, you know, I think it's for them to come in and take a free shot at the team that won the regular season championship.
What do you look to take away from Elmhurst here tonight? I mean, Fiona McMahon, obviously an all-conference player this year, averaging 14 points, 8 rebounds per game. But you've done a pretty good job in the two games against her earlier this season, combined 5 for 12, averaging 8 points and 9 rebounds.
We like the against them, we like to keep them from getting her started and Schwerdman started and getting their inside stuff going. If we, I think they get frustrated because it's so much a part of their offense. If they can't get that going, they start – you know, getting a little antsy, and they start taking some shots that aren't the best shots for them. And, you know, Sennett's a good player at the point, and she's going to shoot the ball a lot, and it's a matter of contesting those and being in the right spots defensively against their post stuff with, you know, all five people guarding that, and then they do a lot of ball screen stuff that we have to handle.
Yeah, Sennett worries me from this perspective, and outstanding outside shooter, 36 of 88, 40% from three-point, and she's one of those streak shooters. If she gets into rhythm and starts going, everything falls in.
Right, and that's, you know, a lot of times with those kids, and we try to get to them early in the game and make sure we're really on top of our assignment, we're really locked into that, and we're contesting all that stuff to make the first couple shots really difficult. Because if you give them easy ones, you know, those warm-up jumpers where nobody's there and they can set their feet, now the confidence really starts bubbling, and then you can really have a hard time stopping somebody. So we like to make sure we're intense. And we usually do a pretty good job of our defensive focus and intensity early in the game and to take that away from her.
Offensively, you've been able to work the ball inside early in the ball games, particularly the game that was played up here back in January. You were able to get the over-the-top work done between Wenzel, Schmidt, Hahn, pretty much take your pick. You've been able to work the inside. I imagine that's where you go with your early part here offensively.
Yeah, and the timing of our offense is always important in the decisions we make with it, because it's hard to guard the inside and the stuff we get off the screening action for our perimeter players. And we've got to be ready to shoot the ball coming off. And if they're really aggressive trying to get to our shooters, then the over-the-top stuff becomes a lot easier to get. And then it's just a function of executing it, making the right pass, and then and finishing the play, because it's hard to take both of those away. And I think like you asked before, the last couple of weeks we've been making – unforced turnover, so to speak, in the tennis, you know, unforced errors in the tennis speak, but, you know, stuff where the ball's got to get to the right spot or the right side away from the defense or to the screener or shooter coming off the screen, and we're throwing it to the wrong side, we're throwing it late, we're throwing it early, you know, those kind of things where it's not clean, and if you get it clean, the shots come in rhythm, and when we get in rhythm, we're really hard to stop.
Speaking of rhythm, I thought maybe in the last three of the last four ball games, I thought Haley Stursic struggled a little bit with her shot, then got a little timid taking the shot. I would hope tonight she's got that feeling that I'm going to make everything I throw up there tonight.
Right, and I think she's probably relaxed about that. And you know, she was pressing a little bit, and I think it was the Elmhurst game and then the game we lost where she didn't shoot the ball well. And obviously that's another component. If she shoots the ball well, it really makes it hard for the defense to focus on Steph or on the post players that way, and Aaron's going to distribute the ball to the other people, and so we have a nice diverse scoring setup there. So it's, you know, to get her started and get her going, and obviously the other teams are starting to, they obviously know. They look at the numbers and they look at the film, and they're going to try to disrupt her a little bit, and we've got to be able to, for her to be ready to shoot the ball when it comes around, and we've got to be able to work to get her open, and she work to get herself open.
Boil it down. What's on the whiteboard here before the Lady Reds take the floor?
You know, the old garden. It's more about guarding the painted area against Elmhurst. You know, you got to contest the three-point shots. Last time they were here, they were 1 for 16. We made them do that at their place, and they ended up going 6 for 32. So they're not afraid to shoot them, contest them, you know, and keep the easy baskets away from them. Either transition or the post-up stuff. Because if we can do that, and they have to work for theirs, they're probably not as good a shooting team or as good an offensive team as we are, and we'll end up getting away.
Good luck tonight.
Thanks, John.
Head basketball coach Tim Bernero, the two-time coach of the year in the CCIW, just announced late this afternoon. Our guest here on our pregame as Carthage Lady Reds get set to take on Elmhurst in the semifinal matchup in the women's CCIW conference basketball tournament. We'll take a 60 break. When we come back, we'll give you the starting lineups, and we'll tip it off tonight from the Tarble Arena in Kenosha. Right after this on AM 1050 WLIP.
The 2014 College Conference of Illinois and Wisconsin Women's Basketball Championship on AM 1050 WLIP. John Weiser with you. The Carthage Lady Reds, ranked 10th in the nation, coming into play here tonight, get set to take on the Elmhurst Blue Jays in the second semifinal game. Again, the winner will face Illinois Wesleyan, a team that defeated Wheaton earlier this afternoon by a score of 79-66. The winners will play tomorrow night at 7 o'clock here at the Tarble Arena. The men's tournament going on down in Bloomington, Illinois. Illinois Wesleyan men winning the regular season conference title there. And the first semifinal game featuring Wheaton and Augustana has gone final. And the Wheaton Thunder have defeated the Augustana Vikings 66-55. So the Thunder advanced to the championship game of the men's conference tournament in Bloomington. Three players in double figures for the Thunder in that ball game: Peter Smith with 19 points, Tyler Peters with 16, Braden Tischer with 11 to lead the way for the Thunder in that victory. Hunter Hill with 10 points for Augustana. The Vikings' season comes to an end, and that may be the death knell for them getting into the NCAA tournament. We'll have to wait and see. Several upsets on the men's side, and some at-large teams will get the automatic bids to some of these conference tournaments, and so that may put Augustana on the outside looking in. The Redmen are taking on Illinois Wesleyan tonight down in Bloomington. We'll keep you posted on how that one shapes up throughout our broadcast here tonight. Of course, we'll keep you up to date on some of the other Division III tournament games going on. The big upset last night, UW-Superior knocking off UW-Whitewater in women's play. So the Whitewater women out of their conference tournament. And Stevens Point also losing to UW-Oshkosh last night in women's play. So UW-Oshkosh and UW-Superior are going to take each other on for the Wisconsin League title tomorrow night. Here it's going to be the Lady Reds and the Blue Jays. Third time these two teams have met. Carthage winning both ball games earlier this season. And the Lady Reds, as I said, ranked number 10 this week in the latest D3Hoops.com poll, and the Wisconsin, or I should say the Women's Basketball Coaches Association Division III poll as well. Let's head downstairs to Adam King, the PA announcer here at the Tarble Arena, for tonight's starting lineups.
Carthage College. The NCAA promotes good sportsmanship by student-athletes, coaches, and spectators. We request your cooperation by supporting the participants and officials in a positive manner. The NCAA, the CCIW, and Carthage thank you for your cooperation. And now for the lineups for tonight's game between the Elmhurst College Blue Jays with a 14-11 record and a 6-8 CCIW record, and the Carthage College Lady Reds with a record of 22-3. And a 13-1 CCIW record. Are you ready? For Elmhurst, a 5'9 senior forward from North Aurora, Illinois, number 3, Devin Vaughn. For Carthage, a 5'8 senior forward out of Island Lake, Illinois, number 12, Aaron Quinn. For Elmhurst, a 5'9 freshman forward from Chicago, Illinois, wearing number 23, Hannah Litman. For Carthage, a 5'9 senior forward from Bloomington, Illinois, number 34, Christy Smith. For Elmhurst, a 6'1 junior center from St. Charles, Illinois, the 00, Fiona McMahon. For Carthage, a 6'1 center from Darien, Wisconsin, she wears number 23, Michelle Wenzel. For Elmhurst, a 5'6 senior guard from Anchorage, Alaska, number 22, Karen Sinnott. For Carthage, a 5'5 senior guard from Chicago, Illinois, wearing number 11, Haley. For Elmhurst, a 5'5 sophomore guard from Oak Forest, Illinois, wearing number 11, Katie 5'8 senior guard from Mount Prospect, Illinois, wearing number 24, Stephanie Kuzmanek. The Blue Jays are coached by Tiffany Perillo. She's assisted by Todd Sherman, Scott Davis, and Natasha Williams. Your Lady Reds are coached by Tim Bernero. He's assisted by Maggie McCloskey and Katie Otto.
So there you have it, the starting lineups tonight for the Lady Reds. Sturcic, Quinn, Wenzel, Kuzmanek, and Schmidt. For the Blue Jays, McMahon, Vaughn, Swanson, Sinet, and Lipman. The officials for tonight's ball game: Rich Chopness, Lachey Hobson, and Mark Rapinski. Lady Reds, the home whites, the white jerseys, white shorts trimmed out in red and black. The Blue Jays, the navy blue jerseys and shorts trimmed out in the light blue and white lettering. Fiona McMahon set to jump center for the Blue Jays. She will go up against Michelle Wenzel. Wenzel suffering a little bit of an injury in practice last night. She went up for a rebound, lost her footing, came down, and as she went down, Taylor Boardman fell on top of her and crunched her chin into the floor, and she's got a couple of stitches on her chin. And it's bandaged up here for the ball game tonight. The opening tip brought down by McMahon. Elmhurst will bring it in play. We are underway from the Tarble Arena. John Weiser with you tonight. The CCIW Women's Basketball Tournament semifinal. Jump shot, top of the circle. Lipman is good. It'll be a deuce just inside the three-point arc. Lipman able to drop it in. 2-0 Elmhurst. Kuzmanek down the floor. We'll set it up to Sturcic. Man-to-man defense here for the Blue Jays. Quinn now up top. Kuzmanek alone for three. That one's off, no good. Rebound pulled in by the Blue Jays. Devin Vaughn able to screen out Christy Schmidt for that carom. Blue Jays bring it down once again. With it now, and we've got an offensive foul setting the screen up top was Karen Sinet making contact with the Lady Red defender Wenzel that time. And Sinet getting the foul on the moving screen. Turns the ball back to the Lady Reds, who trail by two. Just about to get underway down in Bloomington. The Redmen taking on Illinois Wesleyan in the men's semifinal of the conference tournament. We'll keep you posted on that one. Wenzel now inside on the right block, going up over McMahon. Lost control of it. It's taken away by the Blue Jays. She actually hit the bottom of the rim with her shot, looking for a foul. None called. Back the other way. Blue Jays will set it up offensively. Working the perimeter, now dump it into McMahon, low left side, turnaround shot, and the foul. McMahon getting that entry pass at the left block, able to move her way through the paint. Aaron Quinn dropping down to help out defensively on the double team with Wenzel, commits the foul, that is her first. First on the Lady Reds, and on the line will be Fiona McMahon. And McMahon able to drop in the first free throw. It's a very good free throw shooting team. This Blue Jay team, number one in the CCIW. Just a shade under 78% from the line this year as a team. McMahon hits both, and it's a 4-0 Elmhurst lead. A minute and a half into our ball game. Sturcic now off the Schmidt screen to the free throw line. Dumps it left side, Kuzmanek. Over the top feed to Wenzel down low. Too hard off the glass, and it banks off into the hands of Lipman. Lady Reds now 0 for 3 on their first three possessions. Blue Jays will step it up here. Work it through on the loop through to Vaughn. Vaughn will fire it up. That's no good. Wenzel there with the rebound. Clears it out to Kuzmanek. She'll race across midcourt. Kuzmanek down the floor all the way. Flips it down low to Schmidt. Schmidt now back out to Sturcic alone for three. Got it! Haley Sturcic all alone. Top of the arc. Got the return pass from Christy Schmidt. Able to drop it in. The Lady Reds to within one. Sturcic among the nation's leaders in three-point field goal shooting this year. Percentage fell off toward the end of the year. She fell down into that fourth spot now nationally in Division III. Now they loop it into McMahon down low right side, able to skip her way around. Christy Schmidt lay it up and in. McMahon with four, her first field goal of the ball game. 6-3 Blue Jays. 2.5 minutes in here in Kenosha. Schmidt now works it off to Sturcic. Sturcic up top to Quinn. She'll pop for three. That one's a rattle out, no good. Rebound chased down in the corner by McMahon. She will hand it off to Sinette. She'll take it across. 6-3 Elmhurst. They've led right from the start. Now Sinette trying to bounce pass it to the right wing. It's deflected back to Sinette. Now get it in the hands of Swanson. Swanson now on the drive. Turns back, gives it to Sinette for three, knocks it down. Karen Sinette for the triple, and it's a 6-point Blue Jay lead, 9-3, 16:45 to go first half. And she was all alone there, and Lady Red's late getting a hand in her face, and that's what she does. She's a 40% shooter from the arc. Now Schmidt from the outside, that one is short. Nobody there for the Lady Reds once again. One and done are the Lady Reds. Coming down the other way is Swanson. Lady Reds just 1-for-6 now from the floor. Now Lippman back up top. Vaughn into the right corner. Back to Vaughn now, working on the left block. Passes it back out. Sinette again for three. That one skips off the rim, no good. Stursic able to get the rebound. Hands it off to Kuzmanic down the floor. 4 minutes in, Lady Reds down 6. Now Wenzel, top of the circle, driving through the paint, lays it up and draws the foul. Couldn't finish, but will get to the line. Michelle Wenzel on the power drive down the paint, able to draw the foul. Devin Vaughn picks up the foul, her first. That's the second on the Blue Jays. That'll put Wenzel on the line. Michelle Wenzel, senior out of Darien, Wisconsin, Delavan Darien High School. Selected to the first team all-conference earlier this afternoon. Missing on the front end. And the second one also comes up short. The rebound pulled in by the Blue Jays. Blue Jays have out-rebounded Carthage now. 6-2 in the ball game. They lead by 6. Bring it down is Swanson. Swanson now driving to the basket over Stursic, missing. Wenzel able to pick it up. Take it away for the Lady Reds. Gives it off to Kuzmanic. Lady Reds can get into an offensive rhythm here. They have struggled here, 1-for-6 shooting thus far. Wenzel, top of the circle, fires it down low in the paint. Schmidt, turnaround shot, good. Caught that one in the halo right in the middle of the paint that time off the feed from Wenzel. Just turned around and fired it right back up and in. First 2 points for Christy Schmidt. 9-5, Reds down 4. Lippman with it up top to Sinette. Now gets it off to Swanson. Back to Lippman, pulls up, shot blocked from behind by Kuzmanic, out of bounds. And we have our under 16 timeout, stopping play here with 15:07 to go, a 9-5 Elmhurst lead. Well, as we mentioned, the winner of this game will take on the Illinois Wesleyan Titans, who won the earlier semifinal game here tonight, 79-66 over Wheaton. Men's play, they're just getting underway down in Bloomington. It's Illinois Wesleyan and the Carthage Redmen. So we'll follow that ball game for you when we get our updates. Earlier this afternoon, it was Wheaton over Augustana in that one, 66-55 in the men's game. And as I said, just about set to tip off the game in Bloomington with Carthage and Illinois Wesleyan facing off in the other semifinal. The winner will take on the Wheaton Thunder in the men's conference championship game in Bloomington. Lady Reds just 2-for-7 shooting, 28%. Elmhurst 3-for-7, 42%. The Blue Jays are 2-for-2 from the line and 1-for-2 from behind the arc. They have out-rebounded Lady Reds 7-3 thus far. Blue Jay basketball right of the basket as they will inbound following the timeout. They get it in, and it's broken up and taken away by Michelle Wenzel. Wenzel with the steal, hands it off to Kuzmanic. She will bring it down. Works it off to Wenzel, again over the top, down to Schmidt, who was fouled. Got hit across the arm as she caught that pass on the high-low post feed. Swanson picking up the foul, her first, got her across the arm. Lady Reds will inbound left of the basket. We'll get it into Christy Schmidt. Schmidt going down, keeping the dribble alive, got it back out to Quinn. Got out of the paint there just before calling the 3-second call. Again getting the ball, bounced around, got pushed from behind, no call, and it was poked away and taken away by the Blue Jays. He's got that pass in on the top of the left block area and then lost it as firing it up and in from long distance. Karen Sinet, we talked about it in the pregame. She's 2 for 2 now from behind the arc. She's got 6 points. Now we mentioned she is their best three-point shooter at 40%. And if she gets it done, now Lady Reds again turn it over as Quinn lost control of it. And Sinet, or Lippman, I should say, with the steal. Lady Reds down 7 here early on. Sense a little tightness here by the Lady Reds to start this ball game. You wouldn't think of it. They practiced rather loosely last night. And not much change in the routine here, but they've gotten off to a sluggish start. Shot taken there by Vaughn, no good. Rebound Stursic, her second board of the ball game. Gives it off to Kuzmanic. She'll get it to Wenzel. Wenzel backing in on the left block. Turning, shooting, going off the glass and in. Fake to her right, then spun around to her left, put it off the glass over Melanie Schwertman. And Wenzel, her first 2 points of the ball game. Cuts the deficit to 5, 12-7 Elmhurst. 13:25 to go in our first half. Sinet with it, and we got a foul away from the play underneath. Contact between Schmidt and Vaughn. And it's going to go on Christy Schmidt with the body that time. Alexis Hahn will check in for the first time tonight. Hahn, who's been an outstanding sixth man this year. Hahn, a 5'6 freshman, or I should say a 6-foot sophomore out of Itasca, Illinois, coming in for the first time tonight. Boy, she has played spectacularly well coming off the bench, averaging double figures. Doing a good job defensively to get it into Schwertman. Schwertman shot from the left block, pops around and in. Rattled around all parts of the rim before it settled in, and the Blue Jays have doubled up the Lady Reds, 14-7. Kuzmanic now up top to Hahn. Hahn, top of the circle, jumper on the way. That run rattles off, no good. Wenzel able to tip it to herself, though. Gets the rebound and was fouled. Schwertman, I believe, got her across the arm as Wenzel came down with that carom. It's going to go on Swanson, who was also there. Swanson picking up her second. That's the fourth on the Blue Jays. Kuzmanic in quickly to Hahn. Missed it. Got her own rebound. Rejected out of there, though, by McMahon. Fiona McMahon averaging just under 2 blocks per game. Got the swat there. Sinet will fire again from three. That one's no good. The rebound pulled in by Wenzel. That's what they've done. They go back to that last game down at Elmhurst. They jacked it 32 times from three-point range in that contest. Kuzmanic to Hahn, back to Wenzel. 15-footer, no good, but whistle before the shot. She traveled with it. Kim Schwertman will check in, a 5'8 senior for the Blue Jays. Casey Kleiner, the junior out of Shoreland Lutheran, in for the Lady Reds, as is Taylor Boardman in for the Lady Reds, replacing Wenzel and Stursic. 12:20 to go here, first half, 14-7 deficit for the Lady Reds. Blue Jays work it on the left wing. Kim Schwertman inside to Melanie Schwertman, able to lay it up and in. Melanie and Kim are cousins playing on the Blue Jay team, and that time the cousin connection with Melanie finishing it off her fourth point. Quinn on the drive, going to the basket, lays it up and in. Aaron Quinn able to get the layup. 16-9, Blue Jays lead it here. 11:45 to go in our first half. Mel Schwertman up top, dumps it off to her cousin Kim. Kim Schwertman with it, left wing, back up top, Sinet right side. Feeds Schwertman inside, turning around on Hahn. Faked the shot, brought it down out to Sinet. Sinet working around the McMahon screen. Gets it back up top. Melody Schwertman, the jumper there. That curls off, no good. McMahon battling for the loose ball. It's poked around. Quinn diving for it. Still loose on the floor. And it's taken away by the Blue Jays. And then we got a held ball, but a timeout called by Elmhurst. They got possession of the basketball, so a timeout taken here by the Blue Jays. Stopping play with 11:16 to go. Each team given 5 timeouts. They're going to play with the media timeouts here. Because that timeout was taken with the under 12 minutes remaining, this will be a full timeout by the Blue Jays. 11-16 showing, 16-9, Elmhurst on top of the Lady Reds. Gives us a chance to remind you, the 16th annual Seussathon is tomorrow here at Carthage College. The event takes place on the lower level of Hedberg Library here on the Carthage campus. From 9 to 4, you can enjoy readings of Dr. Seuss books, crafts, games, and visits from Dr. Seuss characters. The Carthage Music Theater program will present three showings of Seussical the Musical in the Neiman Media Theater. This event raises funds for early literacy events in Kenosha and Racine counties in honor of Dr. Seuss's birthday tomorrow. This year, Carthage teams up with the Kenosha Public Library to support the Grow a Reader 1,000 Books Before Kindergarten program. And that's all taking place tomorrow, the 16th annual Seussathon here at the Carthage campus. Again, there's plenty of room for you. Bring the family. Bring the kids out. Should be a fun day from 9 to 4 here at Carthage in the Tarble, or I should say in the Hedberg Library. Here in the Tarble Arena, the Lady Reds are down 7, 16-9 as play resumes. Blue Jays will take it back up top. With it is Schwartman, Kim Schwartman. Step back three by McMahon. That one's no good. Christy Schmidt able to pull down the rebound for Carthage. She'll hand it off to Kuzmanek. Carthage trailing by 7 will bring it down. Schmidt up top to Boardman, around to Casey Kleiner. Kleiner in the left wing to Quinn. Quinn will take the dribble, going hard to the basket, going glass, banks it in. Good hard drive that time by Aaron Quinn. Took Karen Sinet right to the basket. Quinn now with 4. 5-point ball game, 16-11. 10:35 to go in the first half. McMahon reversing it around left side into the left corner. Kim Schwartman driving to the basket. And we got a whistle and a foul. And Schwartman will go to the line to shoot 2. Coming up that left side into the left paint. Got hit across the top of the head. Kuzmanek with the foul, her first. Third on the team. And that will put Kim Schwartman on the free throw line for the first time in the contest. Schwartman missing the free throw. Schwartman does not miss many on the line, 94% from the line this year. She makes the second, going 1-for-2. 17-11, Elmhurst leads it here. Approaching the midway point of our first half. Boardman around to Quinn, looking inside, ball's tipped out of bounds off McMahon. Again, a late pass by Quinn, looking for Christy Schmidt. McMahon nearly had the steal, couldn't corral it. Carthage possession here, left of their basket. Kleiner looking to trigger it. Just beat it in, beat the 5-second count as she got it to Quinn. He had a little bit off kilter here early on. It's a credit to the Elmhurst Blue Jays. Put the Carthage a little bit on their heels here through the first 10 minutes. Boardman with 5. With 4, Kleiner loops it inside to Schmidt, lays it off the glass and in, working on McMahon. Shot clock down to 1 as Schmidt banked it in from the right block. Cuts the deficit to 4, 17-13. Clara Monroe with it, works it off far side. Sinet with it, left corner, inside to Schwartman, backing in on Schmidt. Off balance, shot goes down. And she lost control of that pass at her ankles, picked the ball back up while backing into Schmidt on the left block and just all in one motion just heaved it up there. And it found the twine, 19-13. Schmidt up top, able to drop it in. Christy Schmidt for a 3 for the Lady Reds, pulls the Reds 2 within 3. Not going to see that very often. Christy Schmidt on the year. It's 50%. It's 2-for-4 coming into the ball game from 3-point range. Now the Blue Jays will set it up. The lead down to 3. 8:50 to go in the half. Sinet with 7 on the shot clock. Driving top of the circle. Lost the dribble off the ankle, but they're going to call a foul. Ooh. Tough call there. Stursic knocked the ball away from Sinet on her drive, but Shea Hobson on the call. It was a late whistle. She whistled to Stursic for the reach. First foul on Sturcic. Team fouls even now at four. Blue Jays get it in. Sinet will work it around left corner to Kim Schwartman. Back to McMahon, left to the free throw line. McMahon now pulls up over Boardman, curls off, no good. Boardman trying to chase it down. McMahon going over her back, commits the foul. Good job by Boardman to hustle after that miss as it angled off into the left corner, and McMahon bumped into Boardman over her back going for that loose ball. First foul on McMahon, 15th foul on the Blue Jays. Carthage will bring it down, trailing by three. Kleiner, top of the circle to Schmidt, around to Boardman. Left side of the go to Quinn, up top to Sturcic. One dribble, fires the three, rattles off, no. McMahon able to pull down the board. It's the ninth defensive board here for the Blue Jays. As Schwartman back out to Sinet for three. That skips off the rim, no good. Schmidt able to pull it down for the Lady Reds. Under 8 minutes to go here in this first half. Lady Reds down three. Kleiner for three. That's off the heel, no good. Sinet with the rebound. She'll walk it across midcourt. 19-16 Elmhurst. Schwartman now through the circle. Gives it off to Sinet. Sinet now on the right wing. Back up top, it'll go to Vaughn. Deep three, left side. That one's no good. Boardman again snares the rebound. We'll clear it out to Sturcic. Sturcic across midcourt. Finds Quinn left wing. Quinn in the paint to Schmidt, going up strong. Couldn't finish, but drew the foul. McMahon was there. Let's see. She'll be called for the foul, her second. And we got a timeout with 7:26 to play. We'll take a break as well. 19-16, Elmhurst on top of Carthage. Game two of our semifinals here at the CCIW Conference Tournament on AM 1050 and WLIP.com. .726 to go here in our first half. Christy Schmidt on the line. Able to knock that one down. Actually goes two for two here at the stripe. Lady Reds trail by one, 19-18. Carthage down one. John Weiser with you here from the Tarble Arena in Kenosha. 7:20 remaining first half. Carthage trailed by as many as nine here in this first half, but they've whittled it down to one. With it now on the near wing. They work it inside. Schwartman high off the glass. Count it. And one more for Melody Schwartman. Kleiner picks up the foul. Grabbed her across the wrist as she brought that shot up. I mean, it hit the white part of the top of the backboard and then fell in for the bucket. So Schwartman on the line to complete the three-point play. It's up and in. Alexis Hahn into the game now for the Lady Reds. Blue Jays back up by four, 22-18. Under 7 minutes to play here in the first half. Hahn now, top of the circle, ball faking. Takes one dribble, gives it off to Kuzmanek. Kuzmanek high on the right. Gives it up to Sturcic, middle of the floor. Sturcic guarded by Swanson. Now dishes it off to Kuzmanek, to Hahn at the free throw line. Tried to shovel it into Wenzel. It's broken up by McMahon, or excuse me, by Melody Schwartman, and taken away by the Blue Jays. The Lady Reds, their third turnover of the ball game. They work it inside to Schwartman. Lost control of it. Picks it up in the left corner. Now she sends it off to Sinet. Sinet's bounce pass. Gets it back out. The three on the way. That one rattles off. No good. Alexis able to get there for the Lady Reds. Gives it off to Kuzmanek. Kuzmanek down the floor. Hands it off to Wenzel. Wenzel backing in on the right block is double teamed. Back out to Kleiner. Kleiner up top to Sturcic. Now back to Wenzel. Wenzel on the drive through the paint. We got a hand check and a foul call. Wenzel on the drive. Melanie Schwartman picking up the foul, her first. That's a 17 foul, so Wenzel on the line shooting the 1-1. Quinn and Schmidt in, replacing Kleiner and Alexis Hahn. Wenzel 0 for 2 from the line tonight. Able to drop that one in. 3 points tonight for the first team all-conference selection, making first team this year, joining Stephanie Kuzmanek on that first team selection as Wenzel hits the second, 2 for 2 that trip, 2 for 4 from the line. 4 points tonight for Michelle Wenzel. 22-20, Elmhurst up by 2, under 6 minutes to go. We're in the first half here of our second semifinal game. The winner faces Illinois Wesleyan tomorrow night in the championship of the conference tournament. Now Schwartman driving left side. We got a whistle and a foul. Hand check on Wenzel that time. Trying to size up Schwartman as she got that pass below the free throw line. Stuck the left hand into the hip and commits the foul. That's her first. The sixth on the Lady Reds. Blue Jays will inbound left of the basket. Work it back up top and around to Sinet. Right side it'll go. Down in the hands of Vaughn. Back out to Sinet for three, drops it in. Karen Sinet, again a streak shooter. She's 3 for 6 now from behind the arc. She has 9 points. 25-20, and now a steal up top. Errant pass, Devin Vaughn will take it down, will lay it up and in. Again, the unforced errors tonight by the Lady Reds. That's their fourth turnover, and the fourth point off that turnovers. Quinn now, top of the circle to Wenzel. Back out to Stursic for three. That one settles in. Haley Stursic, boy, they needed that one. Pulls the Lady Reds back to within 4, 27-23. 4:50 to go here in the first half. Swanson now, up top, into the hands of Vaughn. Back to Lippman. Now tried to force it inside to Schwartman. It's taken away by Wenzel. Good read by Wenzel that time to come over the top in front of Schwartman to take that one away. Now Kuzmanek will set it up to Wenzel, top of the circle. Looking inside, back out to Stursic. Stursic now to Quinn, top of the circle. Driving, going hard to the basket. Lays it off too hard. Wenzel with the rebound. Stick back won't fall. Got it a second time. Counted in one for Wenzel. That's lunch bucket effort there. Collected the miss by Quinn, then Wenzel missing her own shot, got her own rebound back, and then the second time back up. Able to draw the foul. Wenzel's free throw up and in, completes the three-point play. Lady Reds to within one, 27-26. 4:15 to go in our first half. Swanson now will set it up high in the left wing. Works it off to Schwartman, middle of the floor. Drifts off to the right side. Now back up top to Vaughn. Into the hands of Sinet. Now works it left corner, Swanson. And we get a moving screen as Stursic tried to fight her way through. Was dropped by Devin Vaughn. Vaughn slid the shoulder into Stursic to commit the foul. We've got a timeout here in Kenosha. Elmhurst leading the Lady Reds 27-26. We'll take this break, a 60 break on AM 1050 WLIP. I'm back, here I am. I wanted to get the signal better. That's fine.
Michelle!
Okay. Back-to-back baskets by Michelle Wenzel, and the Lady Reds have taken a three-point lead, 30-27. John Weiser back with you at the Tarble Arena. We apologize, we had a bad signal we took care of here during that commercial break. 2.5 minutes to go here in the first half. Lady Reds up three. They trailed by as many as nine, but Wenzel back-to-back buckets have given the Lady Reds the lead. Blue Jays will set it up offensively here. Dump it inside, looking for Schwartman. We got a bump and a foul on the entry pass over the top to Schwartman. She was bumped off the play by Haley Stursic. That's the second foul on Stursic. The eighth team foul on the Lady Reds, and that will put Schwartman on the free throw line. Ellie Schwartman, 1-for-1 from the line tonight. She has 9 points. She's 4-of-5 from the floor. She has had her way inside throughout this first half. Gabby Chapa on the floor along with Casey Kleiner for the Lady Reds and Alexis Hahn. Free throw is good by Schwartman. Second one up, no good, but the rebound pulled in by Devin Vaughn. 30-28, Lady Reds by two, 2:10 to play here in the half. Sinet now will work it back up top to Schwartman. Around the near wing, it goes to Katie Swanson. They work back inside. Schwartman able to make the catch through the paint, lay it up and in. Getting to the spot on that floor before Wenzel. Able to get it all in one motion. Schwartman with a fine ball game here. 12 points now for the Blue Jays. We're tied at 30. Chapa now up top, around to Quinn, top of the circle. Drifts off to the right wing. Bounce feed to Hahn. Back inside it goes to Wenzel. Wenzel turning, going glass, left side, lays it up and in. Six straight by Wenzel. And she now has 13, 32-30, Lady Reds by two. Now Sinet on the dribble, will hand it back off to Swanson. Swanson in turn, hands it off to Lippman, back inside, layup good. Devin Vaughn off the feed from Lippman, driving right side, able to lay it up and in. Lady Reds unable to stop the Blue Jays here. But last time the Blue Jays were in here, they couldn't hit anything. Tonight, they've got their shooting goggles on as Wenzel missing from the free throw line. That's no good. Rebound Blue Jays, under a minute to go here in this first half, and we're tied at 32. Sinet with it high on the right wing. Looks it off to Vaughn, and we got a whistle and a foul on the Lady Reds. It's going to go on Quinn. That is her second. It's the ninth team foul on the Lady Reds, and that will put Devin Vaughn on the free throw line for the Blue Jays.
Into the Blue Jays lineup is number 10, Kim Schwartman.
Kim Schwartman will check in for the Blue Jays.
Also into the Elmhurst lineup.
Also, Stursic will come in for the Lady Reds, replacing Chapa. Nikki Mullen will check in for the first time tonight for the Blue Jays, a 5'10 junior out of Greenwood, Indiana. At the line is Devin Vaughn, able to hit. Vaughn 82% from the stripe this year, averaging just under 6 points per game. Started all 26 games this year for the Blue Jays, drops them both in. Erica Johnson will check in now. 44 seconds to go, first half. Carthage down two, 34-32. Kleiner will hand it off to Stursic. Stursic gave up the dribble, top of the circle. Needs help, finds Hahn. Now Hahn off to Quinn, back to Hahn, top of the circle. Left side it goes, Kleiner. Back up top to Stursic, takes the dribble over to the right side, outside the arc, denied there. Gets it back to Quinn. Quinn spinning, bounce feed back to Hahn. Hahn 15-footer, rims out. Oh my. Hung on that rim as it curled around, missing. Blue Jays get the rebound. They'll play it for one. Karen Sinet with six, with five. Working on Kleiner, forced it inside. Hahn able to take it away, couldn't corral it. And the shot got off, but did not get in by Kim Schwartman. And the Blue Jays have come to play here tonight. They've given the Lady Reds all that and more through the first 20 minutes.
Elmhurst with the two-point lead, 34-32 over the Carthage Lady Reds. The four seed on top of the one seed through the first 20 minutes. We'll pause, take a two-minute break. When we come back, we'll run the numbers here of our first half. We'll get you caught up on what's going on in Bloomington between the Redmen and Illinois Wesleyan in their semifinal game as our halftime programming begins right after this on 1050 and WLIP.com. Here it's the Lady Reds trailing by two, 34-32 through one half of play. The Reds have to do a better job inside. You heard Tim Bernero mention during our pregame, need to guard the paint. And so far, the inside game of Melody Schwartman has won out. She has 12 points on 5 of 6 shooting, all from within 3 feet of the basket. The Reds have to stop that play, and they have to get out and defend Karen Sinet. Sinet off to a 3 for 6 start behind the three-point arc here tonight. She has 9 points. That's the difference in the contest thus far. The three-point ability by Sinet and the fact the Lady Reds out-rebounded 18-14. When you break that down even further on second chance points, teams are even at 3 in that category, but it's the bench scoring that also jumps out at you here after one half. Blue Jays outscoring the Lady Reds from the bench tonight, 13-0. Lady Reds trailed by as many as 9, led by as many as 3, but trail here as we get set to start the second half, 34-32. Sturcic, Quinn, Wenzel, Kuzmanic, and Schmidt out there for the Lady Reds. It'll be McMahon, Vaughn, Swanson, Sinet, and Lippman for the Blue Jays. Elmhurst making their first appearance in 4 years in the conference tournament. They brought their A game here tonight. Again, earlier this season, they really struggled here at the Carthage Tarble Arena back in January. Just 29 of 61 in that ball game. 12 of 52 in that ball game, 23%. They've already had that many field goals through the first 20 minutes here of this contest. It'll be Lady Red basketball to start our second half. Carthage will put it in play from midcourt. And we are underway with our second 20-minute frame. John Weiser with you, 1050 WLIP Kenosha. And WLIP.com as they try and work it inside to Schmidt. Ball deflected out by Devin Vaughn. Carthage will retain possession left of the basket. Monick gets it into Wenzel. Wenzel on the right block, leans it over McMahon, lays it off the glass and in. Michelle Wenzel with 15 points here in this ball game. The lead all scores, ties the game at 34. Lippman with it now, works it back up top. And in the hands of Vaughn. Vaughn now driving around Schmidt, reverse layup left side, good. No help out that time once she got past Schmidt. Christie was looking for some help defensively, but none coming, and the easy layup by Devin Vaughn, 36-34. Again inside to Schmidt, and she was hammered on the right block. Devin Vaughn commits the foul, that's her third. That's 3 on Vaughn. McMahon has 2. Katie Swanson also with 2, but Christy Schmidt will head to the line, shooting a pair. Schmidt missing for the first time tonight from the line. She's now 2 of 3 from the stripe. 9 points for Christy Schmidt. Second team all-conference selection this year. Makes the second, pulls her team to within 1. We're in the first minute of our second half. 36-35, Elmhurst leading. Now Swanson dishes it back. Sinet with it high on the right wing, guarded by Quinn. Looks around near side, Lippman. Now back to Vaughn. Vaughn through the paint. Skip pass in the left corner to Swanson. Swanson back to Vaughn. Vaughn on the drive, got away with a walk, lays it up and in. Well, she shuffled the feet before she put it down, then drove the basket without putting the ball on the floor. Awfully close to a travel there, but they let her play on for the layup. 38-35, Blue Jays. Now Quinn, top of the circle, left side. Works it off to Wenzel. Wenzel pulls up. Free throw line jumper over McMahon is good. Well, feed it to the hot hand, and that's Michelle Wenzel. Wenzel now with 17 points. She's now 7 of 10 from the floor. Well, Swanson driving through the top of the circle. Hands it off to Sinet. Back up top, it'll go to Lippman. Back to Swanson. Sinet with it, right corner, guarded by Quinn. Gets a screen from Vaughn, dribbles off that screen. Steps back, fires the three. That one is short, rebound, sharp one, right back to Schmidt. She'll get it off to Kuzmanek. Kuzmanek across midcourt. Kuzmanek looking for her first points. Pulls up, going glass, no. Wenzel with a rebound, stick back, good. Kuzmanek missing the rebound, angling off to the left side, gobbled up by Wenzel, lays it up and in. The Lady Reds by one, timeout taken by the Blue Jays. So an early timeout by Elmhurst. They have three remaining. 17:40 to go here in our ball game. 39-38, Lady Reds with a 1-point lead. Lady Reds outscoring Elmhurst here early on, 7-4 in this second half. Now, Illinois Wesleyan has come back to take a 2-point lead at the half. 36-34 over the Carthage Redmen down in Bloomington. Jordan Nelson with 10 first half points to lead the way for Illinois Wesleyan. Meanwhile, for the Carthage Redmen, Marlon Sr. with 8, Malcolm Kelly with 6, and Reese Hirth and Kevin Sykes with 5. So the Titans have come back, trailing by as many as 5 in that first half. Lead it by 2, 36-34 at the half in Bloomington. Here the Lady Reds lead it by 1, 39-38. Michelle Wenzel leading all scorers with 19 points tonight for Carthage. It'll be Blue Jay ball in the backcourt. They'll bring it up uncontested. Lady Reds, a little bit of a zone defense here as they put it up inside, blocked by Wenzel, and as she went for the loose ball, her and Devin Vaughn were fouled. What do we have here? Foul's gonna go on Devin Vaughn. Ooh, Lady Reds got a break there. Lachey Hobson made the call. She grabbed the jersey of Wenzel, it appears. That's what Lachey Hobson is talking to the coaching staff here for Elmhurst down below, saying it was Vaughn who got Wenzel on the jersey. That's two, that's three, I should say, on Vaughn. So Vaughn will have to sit down here as Kuzmanek will get it into Wenzel. Beats the double team, going glass, counted and one. Oh, what a move by Wenzel on the right block. Got the feet from Kuzmanek and then spun, faked the spin right, then spun left on the right block and laid it off the glass. McMahon with the foul, her third. And Wenzel on the line for the third time tonight for the and one, and she does. 22 points tonight for Michelle Wenzel. 42-38, largest lead at 4 now for the Lady Reds. Schwertman works it off to Sinet. Down to the corner, Swanson. Cross court feet back to Sinet. Inside it goes Schwertman. Turnaround shot blocked by Wenzel. Pulled down by McMahon. Goes off the glass and in. Now Wenzel got the original block, but it went right to Fiona McMahon, and then she was able to drop the shoulder and go into the right block and off the glass in front of Christy Schmidt. 42-40. Now Stursic, top of the circle, three! Yes, sir! Haley Stursic with the triple. Her third triple. Timeout taken by the Blue Jays. Their second one here in the last minute and a half. They're down to 2. It'll be a full timeout. And, no, it'll be a 30-second timeout. We'll keep it here. I want to remind our friends, we've got a very special guest coming to Carthage here later on this month. ESPN reporter Lester Munson will be a guest here at Carthage College making a presentation, Sports, Money, and Power. That'll take place at 6 o'clock Tuesday night, March the 11th, right here in the Tarble Arena. That event is free and open to the public. You want to get in here for that. ESPN reporter Lester Munson speaking here at Carthage College. And he will be making a presentation here at the Tarble Arena on Tuesday night, March the 11th at 6 o'clock. And for more information, head out to the website, carthage.edu. Lady Reds up 5, 45-40 here, early second half. Blue Jays down to two timeouts remaining. They've come unglued here just a little bit. Sinet now top of the circle. Forced the bounce feed and drew the foul. Stursic with the reach, picks up the foul, her third. So Haley Stursic with the foul. Again, trying to deny that entry pass into the paint. Connected across the arm. Kalia Summerlin will come in now, a freshman for the Blue Jays out of Valencia, California. Casey Kleiner in for the Lady Reds, replacing Stursic. 45-40, Carthage here. 3.5 minutes into our second half. Schwertman blocked again by Wenzel. Picked up by Quinn. Third block of the game for Michelle Wenzel. What a game she has had. Inside it goes to Wenzel, going glass, lays it up and in. Michelle Wenzel with 24 points. And it's a 7-point Lady Red lead. Inside to McMahon was bumped. And I believe it's going to go on Wenzel. That's her second. Michelle Wenzel with a body bump on McMahon. The under 16 timeout, 15:46 to go. We'll take a break. Lady Reds have built out a 7-point lead. It's Carthage 47, Elmhurst 40 on your home for Lady Reds basketball, AM 1050 and WLIP.com. Blue Jays inbound the basketball following the timeout. They get it into Sinet. She drops it in from 16 off the right baseline. 47-42. Lady Reds have outscored the Blue Jays 15-8 here through the first 4-plus minutes. Schmidt now backing in, spinning, going to the glass, and draws the foul. Backing in the paint that time. Foul will go on Nikki Moen. Moen forced to get in the post here. Mone, 5'10 junior out of Greenwood, Indiana. And Schmidt missing on the front end of the free throws. Boy, that's been a Achilles heel here for the Lady Reds down the stretch, free throw shooting. They made their free throws in the victory over North Park a week ago Wednesday, but missing four of them here tonight. And seven from the line as Schmidt makes the second. 48-42, Lady Reds up 6. Schwertman into the corner all alone for three and drops it in. Kalia Summerlin, the freshman from California. Dropping that one in out of the right corner, pulls her team to within three, 48-45. Kuzmanek still looking for her first points. Feeds Kleiner inside Schmidt, going hard off the glass and in. Concerted effort here by the Lady Reds to pound the ball inside here in this second half has paid off. Schmidt now in double figures with 13. Wenzel leading all scorers with 24. Again alone in the corner. Three ball on the way, no good. Rebound pulled in by Moen. Blue Jays will reload. Swanson that time was left alone in the left corner. Now Moen with it. Back up top to Sinet. Looks it around to Swanson. Back to Sinet driving. Kick out. Swanson again left alone for three and again drops it in. The Lady Reds are losing track of the shooters out there once again. It was a Swanson left alone. This time drops it in. Her first points tonight. She brings her team to within two. Now Wenzel off the feed from Schmidt. Lays it up and in. The over-the-top feed. Michelle Wenzel now with 26. Reds leading here. Out of the corner for three. That one rips out, no good. Rebound pulled in by Quinn. Summerlin that time launching another three. Quinn able to clear the rebound out to Kuzmanek. Kuzmanek down the floor. Dishes to Wenzel. Wenzel driving and was fouled. Summerlin got her across the arm as she made the break toward the basket. Blue Jays pick up the foul. That's their fifth. Hahn and Stursic back in for the Lady Reds, replacing Kuzmanek and Schmidt. And Kuzmanek still looking for her first points tonight. Kleiner will trigger the inbound left of the basket. Gets it to Wenzel. Wenzel back up top. Works it to Quinn. Wenzel playing with a couple of stitches in that chin. Suffered an injury last night in practice. Kleiner gets it to Wenzel. 17 to shoot. Wenzel backing in the paint. We got a 3-second violation on Alexis Hahn. Turning the ball over. Just the fifth turnover by the Lady Reds here tonight. In case you're wondering, the record in tournament games for most points, Lindsay Long of Elmhurst had 32 back in 2010 as that one squirts around the rim and in. Was able to drop that one in with Swanson again. She has six, 52-51. They're back to within one. Reds had pulled out to as much as a 7-point lead, but 6-0 run here by the Blue Jays. Stursic for three. That one's short, rebound pulled in by Swanson. Chance for the Blue Jays to regain the lead here with 12 and a half minutes remaining in our ball game. Sinet with the dribble. Works at top of the paint, Damone into the corner. Swanson again for three. That one lips out, no good. The Lady Reds got away with that one. Again, they left Swanson alone for the three ball. Wenzel able to clear out the rebound. Now Quinn will feed Hahn right corner. Back to left side to Stursic, around to Kleiner. Kleiner on the drive, pulls up short. Little running one-hander came up short. Schwartman able to clear the rebound. 52-51, Lady Reds under 12 minutes to go. Owen with it now, left of the free throw line, driving, gets a screen, count it, and one. Danced around the rim, Nikki Moan finally fell through. Puts her team in front and an and one to boot. We'll take a timeout here, 11:50 to go. We'll get the under 12 media timeout. Elmhurst has reclaimed the lead here, 53-52. So they battled back here. Lady Reds, after jumping out to a 7-point advantage, it was 47-40 Lady Reds, but a 13-5 run now by the Blue Jays, capped off by the 3-point play upcoming here by Nikki Moan. On the foul by Aaron Quinn, and the Blue Jays looking to go back up by two. Again, the winner will face Illinois Wesleyan in the championship game. Wesleyan knocked off Wheaton earlier tonight by a final of 79-66. The fourth-seeded Blue Jays giving the Lady Reds all they can handle here tonight. It was like this down in Elmhurst in their last meeting, middle of the month. Finally, the Lady Reds got some separation about this point in the ball game at Elmhurst just a couple of weeks back. Nikki Moan will get to the free throw line to complete the and one. Okay, 7 of 10 from the line, make it 8 out of 11 as Moan drills the free throw. 54-52, Blue Jays. Kuzmanek still held scoreless here, gives it off to Stursic. Top of the circle, works it left side, Kleiner. Into Wenzel, Wenzel driving, counted and one! Michelle Wenzel, 28 points tonight with one more upcoming from the stripe. My goodness. Wenzel completes the three-point play. Season best for Michelle Wenzel. She had 26 against North Central back on January the 11th. And is knocking on the door on the conference tournament scoring record. Lindsay Long holds that with 32. Reds up by one here. Step back shot, top of the circle. Tough shot there. It's a good guard by Kleiner that time. Up top on Swanson, and she missed the jumper. Kuzmanek now inside Wenzel. She'll lay it off the glass and in. 31 points tonight for Michelle Wenzel. And the Lady Reds open a three-point lead, 57-54. A collegiate best for Wenzel tonight. And Hahn with the steal up top in front of Moan. Hahn will take it down. Over Moan and lay it up and in. Alexis Hahn with the steal in the bucket the other way. And Carthage back up by five, 59-54. 10:35 to go here in Kenosha. Now Wenzel, game of her life as Moan fires up a three. That's no good. Ball tip. Brought back down by Kalia Summerlin. She'll hand it off to Sinet. Back to Swanson now on the left wing, guarded by Sturcic. Up top to McMahon. Ball faking. Now turns. Passes off right side Summerlin. Back to Sinet. Now inside through the hands of McMahon. Taken away by Hahn. Pass too hot for McMahon that time. Hahn with the steal. Kuzmanic. Oh, no look pass looking for Wenzel. Threw it away.
Elmhurst substitutions.
Elmhurst will make a couple of changes here. Devin Vaughn back in. Vaughn with four fouls. Back on the floor here. Midway through the second half, a five-point Lady Red lead. They trailed by as many as nine early in the first half. Led by as many as seven here in the second. Trailed by two, 54-52, but have gone on a 7-0 run. Whistle and a hand check by Kleiner that time on Sinet as she made her move to the basket from the right wing. Kleiner, her second. That is the fourth team foul on the Lady Reds. So the Blue Jays will inbound, free throw line extended. They'll get it into Sinet. She'll work the basketball through the top of the circle. Feeds Swanson high on the right. To Schwertman in the circle. Now gives it back, got a whistle and a foul. Fighting through the screen again was Kleiner, and she picks up her third. Oh, check that. It's gonna go on Kuzmanic. That's her third. Rough game for Stephanie tonight. That's her third foul. Kuzmanic 0-for-2 from the floor. Aaron Quinn will check in for Kuzmanic. Kosida Capital One, academic, Division III, All-American Player of the Year. Struggling tonight. The Reds are gonna have to ride the back of Wenzel here, it looks like. She's had a career game, 31 points tonight, 1 point off the conference tournament record. Now Sinet high on the left wing. Works it back into the hands of Vaughn. Vaughn driving over Hahn, count it, and one, coming up for Devin Hahn. Devin Vaughn going over Alexis Hahn. Hahn committing the foul, that's her third. Check that, her first. Christy Schmidt will check back in here for the Lady Reds, and Devin Vaughn to complete the three-point play. Vaughn with 12 points tonight. Make it 13. Bulls are teamed to within two, 59-57 as we approach 9 minutes to go here in Kenosha. And the winner takes on Illinois Wesleyan tomorrow night at 7 right here at the Tarble Arena. Tickets $6 for adults, $3 for kids and senior citizens. Kleiner, the pull-up jumper right side. That won't go. And the rebound pulled in by Vaughn. Chance to tie or take the lead here for the Blue Jays. 8:45 remaining. Sinet now. Through the top of the circle. Passes it back right side. To Swanson, to Schwertman, back to Sinet. Now to Vaughn. Vaughn into the corner near side. Monroe takes the dribble back behind the arc. Monroe off balance to the basket, lays it up and in with the left hand. We're tied at 59. Claire Monroe, her first 2 points of the game. Kleiner will bring it down. Works it off to Quinn. Now to Wenzel. Wenzel backing it on Schwertman, turning, firing, and was fouled. Knocked to the floor is Michelle Wenzel. That's the seventh team foul, so the Lady Reds in the bonus now the rest of the way out. Wenzel fouled in the act of shooting by Schwertman, who picks up her third. And Wenzel with 31 points toes the line here and makes it. tying a tournament record set by Lindsey Long, 32 points against Illinois Wesleyan back in 2010. Wenzel sets the record with that free throw. 33 points tonight for Michelle Wenzel. A collegiate best for her and a tournament record. 61-59, Lady Reds by two, but they drop in the triple. Claire Monroe coming off the bench. Back-to-back jumpers, this one from long range, and the Blue Jays retake the lead, 62-61. Schmidt now left-hand dribble going strong to the basket, lays it up and in. She was working on Devin Vaughn that time. Vaughn did not want to pick up her fifth foul. So Schmidt backed her, took her, actually faced her right down to the basket. 1 point Lady Red lead. Swanson with the dribble. Gives it up to Vaughn. Around to Sinet. Back out to Monroe. Fakes the shot and traveled. Tried to ball fake her way around Aaron Quinn, but shuffled the feet, turning it over. Just the seventh turnover committed by Elmhurst tonight. A well-played game by both teams. We've got a timeout. 7:18 to go. What a ball game. Carthage by one, 63-62 over Elmhurst. Back after the 60 break on AM 1050 WLIP. What a ball game here tonight. 1 point Lady Red lead, 63-62, 7:18 to go. Michelle Wenzel, CCIW tournament record, 33 points tonight for the Lady Reds. Now Schmidt with the basketball for Carthage. Back up top to Quinn. Quinn high on the left wing. Bounce feed to Schmidt, top of the circle. Feeds Kuzmanic. Kuzmanic held without a point thus far. Pulls up, right baseline jumper. That skips off the rim, no good. Schwertman able to get the rebound for the Blue Jays. Kuzmanic now 0 for 4 from the floor tonight. Now Quinn, and we got a blocking, or a check that Sturcic called for the foul. Awfully close to a moving screen. They call a foul on Sturcic, that's her fourth. Was Swanson trying to set the ball screen for Devin Vaughn. Both her and Sturcic collided at about the same time. But they said that Swanson got the feet set to establish the pick without throwing a shoulder into Sturcic, who went tumbling to the floor, picking up her fourth foul. Vaughn able to tie the game from the line. Devin Vaughn with 14 points tonight. She's 4 of 4 from the line. Playing this latter part of the second half with four personal fouls. Able to drill both free throws, and the Blue Jays back up by one, 64-63, as Fiona McMahon will check in for Vaughn. Kuzmanic will bring it down. Rough night for her. See if she can overcome that as she gets it off to Kleiner high in the left wing, back to Quinn right side. Quinn ball faking, back to Kuzmanic high in the right wing. Got a whistle and a foul. We got a Schwertman bodying up on Wenzel, and Schwertman picks up the foul. Her fourth, eighth team foul, and now Michelle Wenzel back to the free throw line. Wenzel tonight, 33 points. That is a one off Kuzmanic, and now ties Kuzmanic for the season high. Kuzmanic went off for 34 at Wheaton back on January 15th. That ties Kuzmanic now for the high watermark, and that puts her over the top. 35 points tonight for the senior. First team all-conference performer this year. Wenzel with 35 points. She's 13 of 16 from the floor and 9 of 11 from the stripe. Schwertman traveled. Tried to lose Christy Schmidt as she stopped on the left block, but dragged the pivot foot and turned it back over to the Lady Reds. 6:15 to go. Carthage up 65-64. Kuzmanic circling around, now driving, going hard to the basket. Contact, no call. She ran into McMahon. Looks back at the official like, what was that? Let it play on. Sinette now taking the dribble top of the circle. Gets it off to Claire Monroe. Monroe with the early hot hand. Back out to Schwartman, drills the three. What a shot there from Mel Schwartman. She now has 15. Schwartman, one for two outside the arc now. Blue Jays up two as they get it inside to Schmidt, who was double teamed and fouled. That's the ninth foul on the Blue Jays. McMahon picks up the foul, that's her fourth. So her and Devin Vaughn each with four. Schwartman also with four fouls, and Christy Schmidt on the line shooting the 1-1. Able to nail the front end. Schmidt 5 out of 7 from the line tonight, 16 points. How about Michelle Wenzel tonight? My goodness. Her dad just over to my right, just shaking his head. Got the video camera out, and he's just beaming from ear to ear. 17 points now for Schmidt, ties the game at 67. 5.5 minutes to go. Work it back up top to Sinette. Off the feed from Swanson. Sinette gets a screen from Schwartman, hands it back to Schwartman alone for three over Schmidt. That one is no good. Rebound to Kuzmanic. She'll push it down. Kuzmanic across midcourt. Sets it up right side. Inside it goes to Wenzel. Wenzel turnaround over Schwartman. Missing. Battle for the loose ball. It's picked up by Sinette. For Wenzel, that's just her fourth miss from the floor tonight. She's 13 out of 17. Swanson with the dribble. Gives it off to Sinette. High on the right wing. Guarded by Quinn. Now McMahon, top of the circle, reversing left side, back to Swanson. Inside to McMahon, working on Wenzel, kicks it back out to Sinette. Sinette driving on Quinn, denied by Quinn, pulls up, has to kick it back out. Monroe, a deep three at the shot clock buzzer, missing, but McMahon got the offensive rebound. Blue Jays will reload, 4.5 minutes to go, tied at 67. On the drive, Monroe fouled on the floor. It's going to go on Kuzmanic. That's her fourth. So Kuzmanic held without a point here in this ball game. Picks up her fourth foul. Devin Vaughn will check in for Schwartman. Vaughn coming in with four fouls. Bonus now for the Blue Jays. Eighth team foul on the Lady Reds, and dropping it in, Claire Monroe. Monroe, 6 points tonight coming off the bench. Again, that's been the story. Their bench has been active tonight, outscoring the Lady Reds tonight. Makes both free throws. Outscoring the Lady Reds 29-2 off the bench tonight. 69-67. Blue Jays up two. Kuzmanic spinning, going glass, and there it is. The lid comes off the basket for Kuzmanic, as she gets her first points of the ball game to tie it at 69. As we slip under 4 minutes to go. McMahon, top of the circle, works it off left side to Swanson. Swanson now kicks it off left side to Vaughn. Back out to Monroe. Monroe driving on the left corner around. Kuzmanic had to let her go, missed the shot. Quinn battling with for the loose ball. It's tied up, but taking it out of bounds. What do we have here? Foul? Oh my gosh, Mark Rapinski with the foul call here. Wenzel had her tied up for a held ball. They're gonna call a foul, saying she was over the top of the body. That's three fouls on Wenzel. Tim Bernero coming out, trying to get an explanation. If that was a tied up ball, how could that be a foul? And Rapinski saying, no, she came up and over the top. So when play resumes, we'll have bonus free throws upcoming here. Meanwhile, down in Bloomington, Redmond had trailed by as many as 6 in the second half. They've cut it to 3, 44-41. Titans leading the Redmond, 15 minutes to go in that ball game. Marlon Sr. with 11, Kevin Sykes with 7 to lead the way for the Redmond. Andrew Zimnick with 10, Jordan Nelson with 10 to lead the way for Illinois Wesleyan. Again, 15 minutes to go in Bloomington. It's the Titans 44 and the Carthage Redmen 41. Michelle Wenzel. Quite a ball game tonight for the Lady Reds if you're just tuning in. 35 points tonight. That's a conference tournament record, breaking the old mark of 32 held by Lindsay Long in the 2010 tournament. And her 35 points ties Sandy Burkhart for the fourth most all-time in Lady Red history. Burkhart had 35 against Platteville back in February of 1977. As Monroe makes the first and second free throws. 71-69, Blue Jays by two. It's getting late, 3:35 to go. Wenzel up top to Schmidt, works it around to Kuzmanic. And Kuzmanic, we got a foul, offensive foul on Michelle Wenzel. She can't believe it. Setting a moving screen that time, Wenzel picks up foul number four. So she joins the group. Stursic, Kuzmanic, and Wenzel all with four. Vaughn, McMahon, and Melody Schwartman with four for the Blue Jays. Big possession here for Elmhurst, leading by two. They'll bring it down the full length. Carthage will make a substitution. Casey Kleiner in, replacing Stursic. 71-69, Elmhurst. They led by two at the break. They lead by two here. Carthage had as much as a 7-point second half lead, unable to get some separation. Now McMahon, top of the circle. Works it back off to Swanson. Swanson now to Monroe, drives the basket, laid it short with the right hand. Rebound pulled in by Schmidt. She'll give it off to Kuzmanic. To Kleiner for three out of the right corner. Rims around and down. Shooter's touch for the Sherling grad. It rolled around the rim, danced around, then fell through for the triple. The Reds up by one, 72-71, 2:45 to go. Now Swanson with it, and we got a travel. She tried to hand it off to Vaughn. Vaughn shuffled the feet, turning it back over to the Lady Reds. Ninth turnover by the Blue Jays. And another big possession here for Carthage as Stursic will come in for Kleiner. Kleiner gets a nice hand. So Carthage up one with the ball in the backcourt. 2:35 remaining. Kuzmanic circling around to the right side. Pulls up, feeds inside Wenzel. Laid it short, we got a whistle. And what do we have? A foul call. McMahon on the back of Wenzel, and Fiona McMahon has fouled out. It was a late call. Tell you what, it's one of those calls I don't like. It's the official up top that made the call on the contact underneath, with the one official underneath letting it go and the other official on the other wing letting it go. And that will get the ire of Tefni Carrillo. I don't blame her. It's one of those I've always, boy, it doesn't matter, college, high school, NBA, I never like that when the official way up top at center court calls the foul inside. You have to wonder, how can you see that? You're looking through three or four different players. But a break for the Lady Reds here, as that's the 10th team foul, putting Wenzel on the line. And McMahon, their leading scorer, fouling out. Tough way to go. Wenzel makes the free throw, 36 tonight. That's third best all time in Lady Red basketball history. Make it 37 as she goes 2 for 2 from the line. She's now tied Kathy Mucha, who had 37 back in January of 1976. She's three away from the all-time Carthage individual game record. Now the Blue Jays with it. Sinet, top of the circle, backs it into the paint, kicks it back out. On the drive, Swanson, cut off at the baseline, back out to Sinet. Ball fakes around Kleiner. Now tries to dump it inside Schwartman, going over Wenzel, missing. Rebound pulled in by Wenzel. Hands it off to Kuzmanic, under 2 minutes to go. Lady Reds lead by three. Quinn, left wing, gets a screen from Wenzel, driving, going up with it, lost it out of bounds. It was blocked out of bounds that time. Good job by Sinet to stay with it. Carthage will inbound, left of the basket. Sturcic will come in for Kleiner. 1:50 to play, Lady Reds lead by three. They try and get it in, we got a whistle and a foul, and it's gonna go on the Lady Reds, an offensive foul. Tim Bernero steamed at Mark Rapinski. They're going jaw to jaw. Tim's gonna watch it here. Don't get a technical here, Timmy, come on. Again, that's the same official who made that call earlier, putting Wenzel on the line, calling that one way up top. Again, he was over on the near wing in front of the Lady Reds bench, calling a foul here on the opposite side of the free throw line. Oh, Blue Jays get a break. They'll bring it down. Sinet to Monroe, backs it off outside the arc, guarded by Quinn. Now swings it off to Swanson, left side, back to Vaughn. Vaughn into the corner, Monroe for three to tie. That one is short, the rebound by Wenzel. 90 seconds to go as Carthage will bring it down, up three. Well, if you can work some time here, make it a two-possession game. Quinn up top to Kleiner. Kleiner, bounce feed into Schmidt. She's triple-teamed and was fouled as both Monroe, Schwertman, and Vaughn were both there. They're going to call a foul on Devin Vaughn, and she is fouled out. She'll join McMahon on the bench as a DQ. Nikki Moen will check in. Christy Schmidt will go to the line. So Vaughn fouls out with 15 tonight. Joining McMahon as Schmidt missing the free throw. Ooh. Told you this. Lady Reds team do a better job at the stripe. Their fifth miss tonight. Second one on the way. That one's good. Two possession game. Timeout, Lady Reds. They have three timeouts remaining. The Blue Jays, two timeouts remaining. Each team in the double bonus. The possession arrow favoring the Blue Jays, but the Lady Reds lead it by four, 75-71. The winner of this game will play Illinois Wesleyan tomorrow night, 7 o'clock, here at the Tarble Arena. Doors will open at 6. Tickets will be available at the door, $6 for adults, $3 for kids and senior citizens. All Carthage faculty, staff, and students admitted free with their Carthage ID. We've got just under 1,000 here tonight for this nightcap. 37 points tonight by Michelle Wenzel, the second most ever scored by a Lady Red player, tying Kathy Mucha, who got it back in 76 against Wisconsin-Eau Claire. Cindy Chubabowski has 40. That was set back in 1983 against UW-Whitewater, the all-time mark for Lady Reds. Here we go, Blue Jays bring it in, down four, minute 10 to play. Swanson around the Moen screen, back to Moen, now to Monroe, high on the left wing. Monroe will take it through the top of the circle. Gets it back to Schwertman. Mel Schwertman with it, gets a screen from Moen. Hands it back to Swanson, back to Moen for the three. That's no good. Kuzmanic gets held, and it's a held ball to go back to the Blue Jays as Kuzmanic had possession of it. Crowd looking for a foul, none coming. The tie-up gives it back to the Blue Jays, but I'll flip the possession arrow back to Carthage here. 49 seconds to go, Carthage up by four. Through the hands of Schwertman, it's loose at midcourt, and it's an over and back violation. Schwertman tried to screen Wenzel from getting the ball. It was picked up by Katie Swanson. She began the dribble in the back court with her feet standing on this side of the midcourt line, turning it over. It'll be Lady Red's ball. And Kuzmanic fouled in the backcourt. And this will be two free throws in the double bonus for Kuzmanic as Swanson with the two-hand tag. Well, Kuzmanic, which is 2 points tonight, can help her team out immensely here as this one trickles in. Lady Reds by five, 42 seconds to go. One more free throw for Kuzmanek. Back-to-back Most Outstanding Player of the Year award handed out earlier today. Second one up and in. Carthage will take another timeout. Two possession game here. Lady Reds up six, 77-71. Down in Bloomington. Having some trouble with that score. Looks like it's a live stats have disappeared down there. We'll get it back here. It's a tight 5-point lead over Carthage. The Redmen trail by five with 8.5 minutes to go in Bloomington. Titans 59, Carthage 54. So the Redmen giving Illinois Wesleyan, the number one seed, and fifth-ranked Titans all they can handle thus far. Blue Jays will have to go the full length. Trail by six, 42 seconds to go in regulation. Pair of free throws here by Kuzmanek has made it a 6-point game. Sinet will take it across midcourt, guarded by Quinn. Swings it off to Swanson. Swanson loops it back to Sinet for three. It's on the way. No good. Rebound, Kuzmanek. She'll try and dribble out of traffic and is fouled by Moan. Big board there. Carthage will head back down to my right for a pair of free throws by Stephanie Kuzmanek and a chance to make it a 3-possession game here. And Kuzmanek does, hitting the front end, makes it a 7-point game. Blue Jays will take a timeout. They have one remaining. They'll drop a play here. Should Kuzmanek miss or make this free throw, depending on what they want to do. So Tethny Carrillo taking a timeout. They have one remaining. Boy, what a ball game tonight. Well, it's been exciting. Hope you've enjoyed it at home. 1,000 or so here tonight in the Tarble Arena enjoying this one. The Lady Reds are 30 seconds away from going to the finals of the conference tournament tomorrow night. Again, tickets will be available at the door. We'll open up the doors at 6 o'clock. $6 for adults, $3 for kids and senior citizens. Carthage faculty, staff, and students admitted free with their Carthage ID. Kuzmanek back at the line where she is 3-for-3 tonight. And that one lips out, no good. Missing on that fourth attempt. Rebound, Blue Jays. Sinet quickly down. Top of the circle for three. That one's on the way. It's an air ball out of bounds. It'll be Carthage possession. 23 seconds to go, leading by seven. And you just have to get it in here. They do to Kuzmanek, and she's fouled immediately by Monroe or Swanson. Both were there. It's going to go on Monroe. Her first double bonus and a chance for the most outstanding player in the CCIW as voted on by the coaches this afternoon, Stephanie Kuzmanek, to close this one out at the line. Up and in. A hard-fought game tonight by Elmhurst. They gave the Lady Reds all they could handle. Maybe caught the Lady Reds peeking ahead. Lady Reds watched most of that first game with Illinois Wesleyan. They knew going in they would have to face Wesleyan if they win tonight. Blue Jays come back with it, shoveling it up, missing. Rebound Moan, she'll stick it up and in. Blue Jays will take their final timeout with 12.8 seconds to play. They trail by seven. Blue Jays are now out of timeouts. Carthage has two timeouts remaining, plus the possession arrow. Oh, what a game. In Bloomington now, Titans are pulling away. They're up seven, with 6:45 to play, 63-56. Titans leading the Redmen now. Fifteen points for Jordan Nelson tonight. Lead the way for the Titans. Andrew Zimnick with 12. Redmen getting 15 from Marlon Sr., 11 from Malcolm Kelly. Kelly just 3 for 10 shooting tonight. Carthage down 7, 63-56, with 6.5 minutes to go in Bloomington. Here it's the Lady Reds by 7, 12.8 seconds to play. Carthage will inbound the full length. They will face full court pressure here. Schmidt, Kuzmanic, Kleiner, Quinn, and Wenzel on the floor for the Lady Reds. They'll lead the pass out to Kleiner. Kleiner across midcourt. She was tackled from behind. That's got to be an intentional foul. Kleiner was coming down the floor, and the player just grabbed her in the back by the jersey. Isn't it? Pulled her from behind the jersey. Shouldn't that have been an intentional foul? As it is, it'll be double bonus for Kleiner. Nails the free throw. The Reds are going to escape here. Give a lot of credit to the Tethno and the Elmhurst Blue Jays tonight. They weren't happy to make the tournament. They were here early on. They were here to take down the number one seed, Lady Reds. They're going to come up short here tonight. Three ball on the way. That skips off no good. Schmidt getting the rebound, knocked to the floor. Outlets to Quinn. Down to Wenzel. She'll let it dribble out, and the Lady Reds will head to the conference championship game tomorrow night. And they will take on Illinois Wesleyan as they defeat the Blue Jays tonight, 82-73. A collegiate best, tournament record best, and second most points ever scored by the Lady Reds tonight by Michelle Wenzel. 37 tonight to lead the way for the Lady Reds. Your final here tonight, Carthage hanging on, 82-73. We'll pause and take a 2-minute break. Back to recap this one and visit with head coach Tim Bernero in our post-game report right after this 2-minute timeout on AM 1050 WLIP. John Weiser back with you at the beautiful Tarble Arena on the campus of Carthage College, where tonight the Carthage Lady Reds hang on down the stretch. They get to the free throw line, make their free throws, and knock off the Elmhurst Blue Jays tonight by a final of 82-73. A tournament record 37 points tonight by Wenzel. Wenzel 13 of 17 from the floor, 11 of 13 from the line. She posted her second straight double-double, 37 points, 10 rebounds tonight for the first-team all-conference selection as announced earlier this afternoon. Wenzel, with her 37 points, that ties the second-most point total in a game by a Lady Red player. Kathy Mucha had 37 against Wisconsin-Eau Claire back on January of 1976. So Wenzel gets into the record books with her collegiate best, 37 tonight, and a conference tournament record 37, breaking the old mark of 32 held by Lindsey Long of the Elmhurst Blue Jays back in 2010. But you got to give some credit to Elmhurst here tonight. They came in here with the intent of knocking off the Lady Reds. That was evident early as they jumped out to an early 9-point lead in the first half, only to see the Lady Reds come back and tie it, take an early late lead, only to have the Blue Jays come back and go up by 2 at the half, 34-32. Well, the Lady Reds went to work early in the second half, bounced that lead out to 7, 47-40 on a layup by Michelle Wenzel. But the Blue Jays, not to be deterred, knocked it back to within 2, 50-48 on a Katie Swanson three-pointer with 14.5 minutes remaining. They got to within 1 on another Swanson three-pointer at the 13-minute mark, 52-51, and reclaimed the lead on a layup and a three-point play by Nikki Moen. That put the Blue Jays up 54-52. That would not deter the Lady Reds, however, as they would go up by 5, 59-54. A layup by Wenzel, another layup by Alexis Hahn, and it was a 59-54 Lady Red lead. But Elmhurst came right back. 8:24 to go. It was a tie ball game. Claire Monroe coming off the bench, scoring on a layup to tie the game at 59, and it remained a seesaw affair as teams traded leads, was tied 1, 2, 3, 4 different times in the final 8 minutes. There were 5 lead changes in the final 8 minutes here as Elmhurst led by no more than 2. Their last lead by 2 coming at the 3:41 mark on a pair of Claire Monroe free throws, putting them up 71-69. Carthage would then go on a 13-2 run in the final 3:41 to close that one out, including free throws by Michelle Wenzel, going 2 for 2. Christy Schmidt going 1 for 2 from the line. Kuzmanek going 3 out of 4, 5 out of 7. Check that, 5 out of 6 at the line for Schmidt down the stretch. And Casey Kleiner closing it out on the line with a pair of free throws with 11 seconds to go. And the Lady Reds pull away 82-73, your final here tonight. In the second half, the Lady Reds shot 67%, 14 of 21. For the game, 55%, 26 of 47. Lady Reds were just 2 of 3 from behind the arc in the second half. For the game, 5 out of 10. And Carthage went 25 of 31 from the line tonight. Michelle Wenzel, 37 points, a collegiate best, setting a tournament record tonight with that mark. 13 of 17 from the floor for Wenzel, 11 of 13 from the free throw line. She also chipped in 10 rebounds, had 3 blocks, 2 steals, and 2 assists tonight. 18 for Christy Schmidt, Schmidt 5 of 6, 7 of 10 from the line. The only two players in double figures, Haley Stursik with 9, Stephanie Kuzmanek shut out in the first half, finished with 7. Kleiner with 5, Quinn with 4, Hahn with 2. Mel Schwartman and Katie Swanson, or excuse me, Devin Vaughn, each with 15. Karen Sinette with 11 for the Blue Jays tonight. But it was the Lady Reds behind Michelle Wenzel in 37 points, knocking off Elmhurst tonight by a final of 82-73. Joined now by head coach Tim Bernero. And you and I talked, Tim, in the pregame. Blue Jays, where were they going to come out? Were they happy to be here, or were they going to try and knock down the number one seed? And it was apparent early on their goal tonight, as it should have been, was to knock out the number one seed.
We didn't do a really good job, defending them, obviously. They had their choice of plays. They hurt us inside a bunch in the first half. They hurt us off the dribble in the second half. I guess we made enough stops in the last 5 minutes or 7 minutes or whatever to win the game. But you wouldn't have guessed that this team, their team was in here 6 weeks ago or 5 weeks ago and had 33 points. So give them a lot of credit. That's a great job by their staff and their kids, played real hard. They've got, this time of year, pretty much every team's got seniors. And they got kids that, Vaughn and Sennett are both seniors. And they're proud. And they're going to, they gave us all they had. I mean, they really loaded up on us. And Michelle bailed us out. I mean, we just didn't, she scored, she made free throws. 13 for 17 for the floor. She just, and Christy obviously too. It was one of those where it almost looked like an NBA game broke out because nobody was stopping anybody in the middle of, especially the middle part of the second half. It was, they score, we score, they score, and it was trying to figure a way. And then if you look at things, that we're fortunate, and you make your own fortune there. It looked like they were going to keep stretching it. They were going to keep having that two-point lead. We tie it. Two-point lead. We tie it. Went back and forth like that. And then we got, one that had about 12 parts of the rim by Casey that snuck the three-pointer to put us ahead. I don't remember if they got back ahead, but that kind of, we might have been able to exhale from the fact that, okay, we got ahead of them. Now let's see if they, now we could make a stop and put it away.
Yeah, it was just one of those nights for Michelle tonight, 13 to 17. You just kept feeding the hot hand, and I got to give you credit for at least finding her on the floor, and for the other Lady Red players finding her in all kinds of positions on the paint. They just could not contain her. 24 second half points for her 37 tonight.
Right. And they, you know, they were, you know, Steph wasn't her, you know, aggressiveness or aggressive self offensively. She kind of let things happen. Sometimes she likes to share the basketball, obviously. And, you know, we found something that was working. We, you know, Christy had 18 points, so she did a really good job. You know, she only got six shots, but we were able to get the ball inside and score. And then, you know, and Michelle just, I mean, she made a couple shots that I don't know how they crawled over the rim, but then she made a lot of ones that were, you know, sort of matter of fact.
I was telling the story, what happened in practice was it last night.
Yeah.
Scary moment there where she went down and got her shin buried into the floor after Taylor Boardman fell on top of her and had a little chunk taken out of her chin playing with a bandage on her face and everything else, and overcoming that tonight.
We had to put that bandage away for tomorrow night then, I guess. I don't know. You know. Yeah, it was you know, just kind of through the course of when we were scrimmaging against each other, and their feet got tangled up, and Michelle fell first, and Taylor fell on top of her and kind of landed on her back. And, the, you know, fortunately, you know, I'm sure she's not crazy about having a stitch or whatever in her chin there, but fortunately she didn't hit her nose or her head, you know, where she could have concussed or something along that line. You know, so she, you know, she also a little blood on the floor, and they kind of stuck it, you know, took her and got her patched up for today, and you know, maybe that's her good luck thing. I don't know, but she played great.
Well, and the other thing tonight, you didn't do harm to yourself. You didn't turn the ball over. That's what kept you in this ball game tonight. The fact that you kept those unforced errors. We talked about it in the pregame. We talked about it the other night against Milliken. The unforced errors, if you keep those to a minimum, that gives you a chance. And you only had 8 turnovers tonight, I think 3 here in the second half.
Right. And, you know, that's obviously style of game. They defend a little like we do, that we're not, there wasn't a lot of pressing at all, and there wasn't a lot of overplay stuff that so it was a matter of who's going to execute and who's going to finish plays. And, you know, yeah, it was nice that we made those decisions, and you know, we made free throws, shot 50% from the three and 55 overall. So, you know, I've always believed that in this team and some of the teams we've had the last couple of years, if we get the shot, we get shots, we shoot pretty high percentage.
You got that done down the stretch tonight. I think it was 6 out of 8 from the line.
Steph missed one, I think, and maybe Christy, but I don't think.
Right.
Michelle missed them, or didn't miss any. I think one, you know, and that was when she was on such a roll, and she missed a little jump shot in the lane, and you're like, oh, you know, what's wrong with her, you know, kind of thing. But she was so good, and I think she might have missed her first shot. I know she missed her first shot because she got kind of deep on the baseline here, and then maybe the second one after that. But once she got going, she was pretty special tonight.
Should we be concerned? Alexis Hahn just 1 for 5. The bench as a whole here tonight, not much contribution there, getting outscored 33-7 on bench points tonight. Is that that's got to be a little bit of concern, I would think.
A little bit. I was disappointed, and you know, I suppose it was a tough one because Taylor didn't do anything wrong. It was, you know, and you change how you play the game because of the media timeouts. Is that she's got 37 points. We're getting a timeout every 4 minutes. She's a pretty fit kid that can play a long time. So, you know, I didn't take her out because there was a stretch in the second half where that was all our offense was coming from. And, you know, she was able to, you know, to stay out there all 20 minutes in the second half. You know, I think we just need – Lex had a couple chances. She just needed to be a little stronger on the boards and those things. But Casey made the 1-3 and a couple free throws. So, it was, you know – I haven't lost confidence in those guys, but I don't know that this wasn't the best game for collectively by them. But we, you know, Casey helped out, and Lex got a couple rebounds, and Taylor didn't play badly in the 5 minutes she did in the first half. But you know, I think that's still something we're, you know, they've been really good all year, and they've got to be good now.
Well, now you've got another rematch with that team again, Illinois Wesleyan, the third matchup. This year with Illinois Wesleyan, who defeated Wheaton earlier tonight. Your thoughts going into that ball game tomorrow?
You know, both games were pretty odd in style. I mean, the game here, they jumped us and we're up 11 early. You know, we came back, they had a 16-point lead late in the half. We scored 13 points in a row, cut it to 3, and it was a high-scoring game, 90-83, and we won that one. We went down there. And I don't think either team thinks they played particularly well through the first 30 minutes, and then they had a good burst, and we had a really bad burst, and they came past and beat us. And that, you know, and it's funny because they prefer the high tempo pressing stuff like that, and they turned us over some in the game down there. But the game was 69-57 with us fouling at the end. So I'm not sure that that was exactly how they prefer to play, but they got the result they were looking for. So we won the high scoring game, and we're capable of scoring. We're almost at 80 points a game anyhow. They won the low scoring game. You know, we'll see which way it goes tomorrow night. Both teams had really tough games tonight, and we'll see who bounces back and is ready to go that way. But it'll be a good game.
And on a personal note, congratulations, Coach. Win number 200 in your coaching career here over the last 11 years. Amazing. Congratulations.
You know, like I said before the game, it's the people that you work for and you work with. I mean, you know, the kids don't play for, you know, they're the reason. You know, the reason you do it, they're the reason we're successful. You obviously are the responsible one that oversees the program. And you try to get them to learn things on the court, off the court, that make them better players, that make them better people. But going through that makes, you know, sometimes it's longevity. Those people that win a lot of games just because they hang around, you know. I like to think we're not doing it at, you know, at a snail's pace. We've won them in, you know, at almost a pace of 20 a year in 11 years. And that means we've got a pretty solid program. And it's the people you get from the administration through your assistant coaches and the trainers and everybody that does the stuff to help you get in that position. And then you know, I like to give the credit to the kids, and, you know, but it's nice to get to that one. You know, who knows? You know, you never know how many more you're going to get, so you just keep going.
We got to email Bob Huggins, figure out who got to 200 the quickest.
Yeah, he's all he if we keep going, we'll get he's my favorite one. We'll get to 1,000 eventually, but that's like the time that Bill Wennington was playing for the Bulls, and he said he and Michael Jordan combined for 57 points, and the night Michael Jordan had 55. So I'm at the bottom of this pile, but I'm appreciative of the chances and what we have here at Carthage and the kids and how hard they work and their families and how they support us.
Well, come on out tomorrow night, Tarble Arena, 7 o'clock, the conference championship game, conference tournament championship game. Lady Reds hosting Illinois Wesleyan, and the again, tickets will be available at the door, $6 for adults, $3 for kids and senior citizens. And come on out, let's pack the place. We had just under 1,000 here tonight. Let's see if we get about 1,100 or 1,200 in here and rock this house down and send you off in good note.
It was a great atmosphere. The students turned out. You know, some of the, you know, obviously you had the four teams. You know, some of the fans from those teams hung around. You know, the pep band and the Red Hots were what they always are, great for the atmosphere, and they really bring a lot to it. And I know the kids appreciate it. I appreciate it a lot. And, it, you know, tonight was two really good basketball games. Our game was wild, you know, very entertaining. I mean, probably for our end, we'd have liked it to be less entertaining as far as the score, but it was a fun game to watch, and both teams played pretty well, and it was, you know, a lot of activity for a couple hours for a fair price.
Was entertaining up here, let me tell you. I said a couple of times, this is an exciting ball game. But, Coach, congratulations. You pulled it out here. Their team pulled it out. Got it done when you needed to in the final 8 minutes here tonight. And let's go on and get a championship tomorrow night against Illinois Wesleyan.
And that's what I told the kids. I was really happy for, you know, that we were persevered. I mean, they don't always have to be 30-point wins. You have to figure out ways to do things. You know, Haley fouls out. You got people in foul trouble. You're trying to work through stuff. The kids were able to hang in there and make free throws and make some plays. You know, and I just told them too, is that, you know, obviously it depends which side of the fence you're on. It's obviously more impressive to win the marathon, the 14-game one, as the regular season champs. But they throw these tournaments in front of you, and we're here, and we're playing a rival game. And, you know, we might as well go ahead and win that one too, and get ourselves ready for the NCAA tournament next week.
Coach, congratulations.
Thank you, John.
Tim Bernero picking up win number 200 tonight as the Lady Reds come from behind tonight, knock off Elmhurst 82-73. The final, Lady Reds will be in the conference tournament final tomorrow night here at the Tarble Arena. A 7 o'clock tip. We'll be with you here on 1050 WLIP and WLIP.com beginning at 6:40 tomorrow night with our pregame. Again, Michelle Wenzel, player of the game tonight, no doubt. 37 points, 24 in the second half for Wenzel. That is a tournament record, 37 points, breaking the old mark held by Lindsay Long
from the 2010 tournament. Long had 32 in that game for the Elmhurst Blue Jays against Illinois Wesleyan. Wenzel shattered that mark and moved up the scoring ranks herself. That 37 points, that ties for second most in Lady Red basketball history, as she is going to go in the record book with Kathy Mucha. Mucha, the 1976 against Wisconsin Eau Claire, finished with 37 points in that contest. So record performance tonight for Michelle Wenzel. 13 of 17 from the floor, 11 of 13 from the line. She also chipped in 10 rebounds, 2 assists, 3 blocks, 2 steals tonight. The line on Michelle Wenzel, who was named first team all-conference early this afternoon by the coaches in the CCIW. Christy Schmidt with 18 tonight. 9 for Haley Stursic, fouling out of the ball game late. 3 for 5 from outside the arc tonight for Stursic. Stephanie Kuzmanic struggled, as you heard Coach Bernero say, kind of dished it out tonight and just kind of sat back, watched things develop. Was 1 for 6 from the floor, not very aggressive offensively, but did hand out 6 assists, had 1 block and 2 rebounds tonight for Wenzel, or for Kuzmanic. 5 points for Casey Kleiner. Her big three-pointer with just under 5 minutes left gave the Lady Reds the lead for good down the stretch. Kleiner, 5 points in 25 minutes. 2 points for Alexis Hahn. 4 points for Aaron Quinn. Gabby Chapa and Taylor Boardman played but did not score for the Lady Reds. Carthage for the game, 55%. They shot lights out second half, 14 to 21, 67% in the second half. For the game, 26 of 47, 55%. They were 5 of 10 from behind the arc, 20 for 24 at the line in the second half. For the game, 25 of 31. For the Blue Jays, 15 points each for Devin Vaughn and for Mel Schwartman. Schwartman tonight, 6 of 11, including a three-pointer. For Vaughn, 5 of 8, perfect at the line, 5 for 5. 15 tonight, one of two players to foul out. Devin Vaughn fouling out. Fiona McMahon also fouling out. McMahon with just 6 points tonight. 11 for Karen Sinet. Sinet, 3 of 8 from behind the arc, 4 of 10 from the field. 11 total tonight for Sinet. 9 for Claire Monroe, all in the second half. Monroe, 2 for 7, including a three-pointer. She made all 4 of her free throws tonight, playing 17 minutes, all coming in the second half for the most part. And then she had briefly appeared late in the first half, but all of her scoring coming here in the second half, finishing with 9. Nikki Moen with 5, Katie Swanson with 6, Fiona McMahon with 6, fouling out. 3 points for Kalia Summerlin, 2 for Hannah Lippman, 1 for Kim Schwartman. Erica Johnson played, did not score, played briefly late in the first half and did not score for the Blue Jays. Elmhurst won the rebounding battle tonight, 32-28. Leading rebounder for the Lady Reds was Wenzel with 10, 7 of them on the defensive glass, and she collected 3 of the team's 4 offensive rebounds tonight for Carthage. Meanwhile, leading rebounder for the Blue Jays was Hannah Lippman with 6, 5 of them on the defensive glass. Both teams took care of the basketball tonight. Carthage turning it over just 8 times. That led to 13 Elmhurst points. And the Blue Jays turning it over 10 times, leading to 11 Carthage points. Second chance points, Blue Jays outscoring the Lady Reds 14-5. And the bench points tonight belonging to the Blue Jays, outscoring the Lady Reds on the bench tonight, 33-7, the final in that one. Blue Jays led by as many as 9, that coming with the 12-minute mark of the first half. Carthage, their largest lead, 9. Final seconds of this ball game in an 82-73 victory tonight before just under 1,000 here at the Tarble Arena. They will face Illinois Wesleyan tomorrow night. That'll be a 7 o'clock tip here at the Tarble Arena. It has gone final down in Bloomington. The Titans have ended the Carthage Redmen season tonight, knocking off Carthage 76-71. A valiant try by the Redmen tonight, as the Titans could never quite get total separation from the Redmen. Redmen had a 5-point lead, Titans led by as many as six in the second half. They win by five. Illinois Wesleyan beating the Carthage Redmen tonight 76-71. Marlon Sr. in his final, perhaps his final game as a Redman, 19 points. Malcolm Kelly wrapping up his outstanding Carthage career, won the conference scoring title, was a first-team all-conference selection. He finished with 16. Dante Logan with 10 tonight, the double-figure scores for the Redmen. Jordan Nelson, he did the Redmen in tonight, 17 points. Nelson was 5 of 8 from the floor, including 3 of 6 from three-point range. He finished with 17. Andrew Zimnick, a strong ball game tonight, with 16. Dylan Overstreet, their fine point guard, with 10 for the Titans, who knock off the Redmen tonight, 76-71 in Bloomington. So on the men's side, it'll be Illinois Wesleyan and Wheaton for the conference tournament championship tomorrow night in Bloomington. Here in Kenosha, it will be the Lady Reds and Illinois Wesleyan. For the third time this season, the two arch rivals will meet. That will get underway at 7 o'clock here at the Tarble Arena. Tickets will be available at the door, $6 for adults, $3 for kids and senior citizens. My thanks tonight to Scott DeLabio, engineering our exciting broadcast back at our Pleasant Prairie studios. I'm John Weiser. I hope you enjoyed our broadcast. I know you enjoyed the final outcome. Once again, the final score here tonight, the 10th-ranked Lady Reds go to 23-3 on the year as they knock off Elmhurst 82-73 to reach the conference tournament championship game for the second straight year. We'll have it for you beginning at 6:40 tomorrow night right here on Kenosha's radio station, AM 1050, WLIP Kenosha. Good night, everyone.